Yes, very good afternoon to all. In our previous class, we have seen one example, and in that example, we have discussed the impedance matching, and particularly while matching, we have seen that in that example, there were two real impedance. So it means that the RS and RL both are the real impedance. But in our actual practice, however, whenever we deal with transistors or transmission lines or antennas and so on, we have to deal with the complex input and output impedance. So, for example, I can draw here one simple one transistor, for example, and let it is having some common emitter configurations. Then all of you aware that let this is your collector, this one is your base, this one is your emitter, and all of you aware that whenever we apply some input signal to this kind of the common emitter configurations, see amplifier, then at the output side we are getting some gain. So amplification of input signal will be happen. So in short, I can say that here in this particular case, in reality, when we will look at the input side, then we see that this red in will not be the real impedance, but it will consist of some Ri plus Jxi. And same way, for example, I will look at the output side, then I will always find that some real impedance R0 and some reactance X0. So in short, we have to deal with this complex input and output impedance. So how to deal with this? So all of you aware that this is the thing, but for example, this is your common emitter configurations, and if I will equivalently represent the AC equivalent circuit with parasitic effect, then all of you aware that in your basic class, all of you have studied that there will be some, this is your base, there will be some current flow, which is nothing but your IB, for example, then there will be a common ammeter, this is terminal, is nothing but your ammeter terminal, and there is some parasitics associated with these B terminal and E terminal, and that can be represented by some capacitance, that is nothing but your CVE. And same way, I can express this RI, and this R, I can say that it is nothing but impedance of this impedance looking at the input side, and here at the output side, all of you aware that here you will get some current flowing, and which is nothing but the beta times of that IB, and you will also get some stray capacitance, and that is nothing but the CCE, for example. So in short, I can say that the in this kind of the common emitter configurations, we will get this way some stray capacitance. So once there is a stray capacitance, it means that if I will see that here this input side impedance is now not only a real number R, but it is also associated with some reactance of this capacitance CVE. Same way, the reactance, the CCE will also need to be taken care. So in short, this input and output impedance always having some complex input and output impedance. So while we deal with the impedance matching at the either at the input side or the output side, we have to deal with the this complex impedance. So there are mainly, I can say that the two approach that you can use for the handling this complex impedance. Okay, so the approaches are nothing but A, which is nothing but consider as a absorption type. Second method, and the second method is considered as a resonance method. So I will take in today's class two examples of each of these approach, and we will try to see how the impedance matching can be performed using these two techniques. So let us first see the absorption type method. So in this absorption type method, what we have to do, we have to first of all find out which are the reactants present, and then that stray reactants can be absorbed into the impedance matching network by placement of the each element is in such a way that either you have to add some capacitor or either you have to add some inductors. So once you add, then you need to recalculate the new elements value of that inductor and capacitors, and that needs to be replaced. So let us see the example so that you will get the better idea about this method. So I can say that use the absorption ABM means absorption method to match the source and the source is nothing but 100 plus J 126 ohm, and so this source needs to be matched with the load, and the load is nothing but it is also a complex load. So now the load is 100 parallel to minus J 795.8, for example, ohm. And at a particular frequency, the frequency is nothing but the 100 megahertz. So how to match the source and load resistance at this frequency using the absorption method? So I can draw the same statement in this way. So this is nothing but your R, which is nothing but the 100 ohm, which is connected with some source, and which is nothing but the source is not a now pure real impedance, but it is a complex. So there is a inductance which is in series, and which is having some reactance value J126 ohm. And at the load side, we have a parallel complex impedance, and that is nothing but the 100 parallel to minus J795.8 ohm, and the impedance value is nothing but the 100. Sorry, it's not 100 but 1000. Sorry, it's my mistake. So 1000. So now, what is your objective? Your objective is to use this absorption method to match these two complex loads. So somehow we have to use some matching techniques, and match these two loads. So how to do? So let me try to solve these examples so you will get a better idea. So here, the very first thing that you can see that this capacitance can be equivalently represented by its C number or capacitance value. So let the all of you know that the reactance of this or impedance of this capacitor, which is in parallel, is having a value of the J795.8 ohm. So I can say that that is nothing but equal to minus J over omega C. So very simple. So I can see that I can convert its equivalent to C. So C is nothing but now equal to 1 over 795.8 into goes 2 pi and F. And F is nothing but 100 megahertz. So I can say that 10 raised to 8. So ultimately, I will get 2 picofarad capacitance value. So ultimately, this capacitor is having a 2 picofarad values. So now, what is our objective? Now, we know now that this capacitance is value is 2 picofarad, and this is what the load side reactance. This is nothing but the source side impedance, which is nothing but the J126 ohm. Now, very first thing that you have to do, so the step one that you have to follow is that first of all, you totally ignore this reactance and try to simply match this 100 ohm and this 1000 ohm such a way that the inductors are in series and the capacitors are in parallel. So this steps, I think, is nothing but this is nothing but our matching network that we want to do, that we want to obtain. And this matching network is nothing but I can say that we have to find out this in such a way that we are trying to omit this reactance. So if you omit this reactance, then the problem will become like a in this way. So simple, one source, 100 ohm and 1000 ohm. Okay, so 1000 ohm and 100 ohm. So in our previous class, all of you remember that we have obtained the matching network for this kind of the real impedance, and we obtain. So I'm not once again solving the same example. So please go back with your example. In that, we have seen that how to match this 100 ohm with 1000 ohm with the L network, and that L network was nothing but like in this way. So we have designed in this way that there was one inductor and there is one capacitor, and our objective was to match this 1000 ohm with this 100 ohm, sorry, and we have to find out this L and C. So we have done the calculations. So if I will once again write here that calculation, then I can say that here our RS is 100 ohm. Let me write so that all of you will clear. RP, which is nothing but parallel resistance, that is nothing but our 1000 ohm. And our objective was to find out this L and C. So we know that the QS or the QP, which is nothing but having a formula, which is nothing but the 1000 divided by that 100 minus 1 and its square root. So we obtained the answer was the 3. So once we know this QP, then it is very easy that we can find out the X of X, which is nothing but a reactance of this inductance, and that is nothing but equal to the I can say that QS into RS. And we know that now that Q is nothing but the 3 and the RS is nothing but 100 ohm, so this will become a 300 ohm. And same way, I can find out the because we are looking for the XP, so for that also I can say that XP is nothing but the RP by QP. And we know that now RP is nothing but our 1000 and these QP is nothing but 3, so we will get the 3, 3, 3. Okay, so ultimately I can say that I will get the L and C value is in this way, that the X is nothing but the, I can say directly I can write omega L, I am omitting the J. So what I will get, L will become like a XX by omega, and we know that the XS is nothing but our 300 ohm, and omega is nothing but the 2 pi into 10 raised to 8. So ultimately you will get 477 nanohenry. Same way we are also looking for the capacitance value. The capacitance is nothing but the XP is nothing but 1 over omega C. So you will get the capacitance value C will become 1 over omega C into XP. So you will get ultimately here, and the omega is nothing but 2 pi into 10 raised to 8. So 2 pi into 10 raised to 8, and we know now the XP is nothing but having a 3 value. So ultimately we will get the capacitance value that will become a 4.8 picofarad. So the idea is what, in this absorption method, first of all we have to find out this L and C by simply neglecting this reactants, this J126 ohm and this 2 picofarad. So now we obtained that network is having a now this value. So L is now nothing but our I can write here that the L that we obtained is 477 nanohenry, and the capacitor that we obtained is nothing but the 4.8 picofarad. Okay, so I can say that now while simply replacing the reactants, we obtained this matching network that is equivalently I can represent by this L and by this C, and that network value L is nothing but now over 477 nanohenry, and C is nothing but 4.8 picofarad. Okay, so this is what the first step that you should get. So now we obtained this value by simply replacing or neglecting this reactors. Now because now we have to consider this reactants also. So now the next step 2 is, so in this step 2 what you have to follow, that you have to get the new elements value. How to get the new elements value? So I can say that the new elements can be considered as a, so now new L prime, for example, is nothing but whatever the inductance value that you have obtained, and subtracted by the, because it is an absorption method, so we have to subtract with whatever the inductance that is already been present. So here this is nothing but your J126 ohm. So I can say that it's if you solve this and if you get it, then this is nothing but your LP, then I will get that 477 nanohenry minus this LP. I can also calculate, but I am directly giving that as I have calculated this as a minus J omega C, same way I can obtain that this is nothing but our 200. So L is nothing but 200 nanohenry. Okay, so that 200 I directly have to subtract here. So it means that the new elements that you will obtain because of this absorption method having a L prime value, which is nothing but the 277. So it means the idea is what, in this absorption method, that somehow you have to equivalently represent that counter values, so that that will be emulated and you will get the maximum impedance matching. So same way, the, if I will calculate the new capacitor, the capacitor can be expressed by the same argument, that simply you have to subtract with your new value, which is design and just calculated value in step 1, which is the thing about the 4.8, and we know that the capacitance value of this parallel is nothing but the 2 picofarad, so minus 2. So in short, I will go to 2.8 picofarad. So in short, I can say that ultimately you will get the final design will be in this way. So this is nothing but your inductor. This is nothing but this is your underlying source resistance, which is with 200 nanoamperes. Now you have to add with this inductance, and because this is what that final matching network that we obtain. So this is what that we obtain the final network. This is a number 277 nanohenry, and this is what you have 2.8 picofarad. So this is what your final, I can say, final matching network. So are you getting what I have tried to explain? Yes. So the idea is what? That because our objective was to make the complex impedance, so we cannot directly measure. So here, the using this absorption method, where first of all we have replaced or neglect this reactance value, and then we have tried to find out our impedance matching network using these steps, and then we have find out the new element, which is nothing but our L prime and C prime, and we have added in our final network. So once you add this inductance and reactance, then what will happen? Ultimately, I can say that this impedance, once you see from this side, will become like a ZS, will be equal to ZS prime. So that you will get the maximum power transfer. So this is what the one of the method which can be used. This can be one of the way to get the matching network. But let me clear that this technique is workable only and only if the calculated elements value L and C are higher than that stray values, stray capacitors values. So in short, kevano matlab ke ahiya je L and C che e apanne je aapvama avela hata e L and C ni value che 200 nanohenry ane capacitor ni value che e 4.8 hati. અને જે એલ પી અને સી પી જે મળ્યા એ મળ્યા તમને, દેટ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ યોર સોરી 477 નેનો હેનરી એન્ડ 4.8 પીકો ફેરાડે, અને આપણે જે મળ્યા છે દેટ ઇઝ 200 એન્ડ 2. સો ઇટ મીન્સ એલ એન્ડ સી આર greater than this LP and CP, then and only then you will get this technique will work. Otherwise, this technique will not work because it will give you the minus value and that cannot be realizable. Hence, okay. So with this, I can say that we have used stair reactants. So and using these stair reactions and absorption way, try to mesh the network. So now the second method is considered as a resonance method, in which any stray reactants are resonated with equal and opposite reactants at that frequency of interest. So how to do that thing? So let us see this part also. So 1 minute, hold before I start. 1 minute. Hello, all of you are getting what I try to explain? So this is the one of the way to mesh your complex impedance. Now we try to discuss the second method, and that is called the resonance method. So G method, that is nothing but the resonance method. Okay, so I am directly, let me directly give you the example. So from example, you will clearly understand these techniques. Okay, so in this method, as I mentioned, that any stray reactants, if you are resonated with the equal and opposite reactants, then you will get the maximum power transfer. So let me give you the example. So from example is like a design a matching network. Example like this, design a matching network that will match. Source resistance, that is given by RS, is equal to 50 ohm to a capacitive load. So now load is reactive load for having some complex impedance, and at for example at 75 megahertz. Okay, so the network is looking like in this way. For example, this is your source impedance, RS, and which is nothing but the 50 ohm. Now you are trying to design the matching network. The load is nothing but capacitive, and there is some resistive load too, and that is nothing but 6600 ohm. And this capacitance is nothing but the 40 picofarad. It is given. Okay. So what is your objective? So your objective here to design such a matching network, using this resonance method. Okay. So first of all, as I mentioned that in these techniques you have to find out the equivalent reactance value, which will resonate this load, reactive load. So how to get the resonating, suppose this is your capacitor. So in short, you should have such a inductive effect which actually resonant at that particular 75 megahertz. So how to get that? So there are some steps. So the step one is that resonant, first of all, this 40 picofarad with some shunt head, with shunt inductor, the Bridge L1. So how can I get this inductance value? So inductance value is nothing but because you are trying to get the omega L1 should be resonant with this capacitor, which is nothing but 1 over omega C. So what will happen? This L1 will become like a 1 over C omega square. So we know that now the L1 will become 1 over C is nothing but our 40 picofarad, so 10 raised to minus 12, and 75 into 10 raised to, sorry, 1 minute. six, and it's all square. So if you solve this, you will get the inductance value that is nothing but 112.6 nanohenry. So this is what the inductance that you will obtain for resonating that 40 picofarad capacitor, capacitive load. So now what is the next figure that you will obtain? So here you will get in this way. So now you obtained this type of the inductive values, which is nothing but the L1, which is having a value of some 112.6 nanohenry. There is a some capacitor. There is a 600 ohm load resistor. So this is what for the 40 picofarad. So in short, when you look at idea is what you are trying to design the resonating network. So here, because now you have a resonating network, so L1, and because of this C, you will get the input impedance will look like a pure resistive network, and which is having an impedance 600 ohm. So it means that now you add one resonating network so that input side impedance become the simple your resistive load. એટલે જોનો મોટો આપણે શું કર્યું કે જેવું રિએક્ટિવ ઇફેક્ટ હોય ને નલિફાઈ કરી દેવાનું, અને આપણને આ પોઈન્ટ ઉપરથી અહીંયા અહીંથી જોતા આ પોઈન્ટ ઉપરથી જોતા ડાયરેક્ટ 600 ઓહમ જ બતાય, અને વચ્ચેનું જે આ જે રિએક્ટિવ જે લોડ હોય એ નલિફાઈ થઈ જાય. તો નાઉ વોટ? તો સ્ટેપ ટુ ઇઝ સિમ્પલ. Step 2 is that now we have to match simple, because we know, so we have to match simple RS with RL, match 50 ohm and with that 600 ohm. So it's very now simple steps that we can follow for obtaining that network. So આપણે જે હમણાં એક્ઝામ્પલ જોયું એમાં કઈ રીતના કરતા હતા કે ભાઈ અવર આઈડિયા વોઝ ટુ મેચ ધીસ એમ એન્ડ 600 ઓમ, આ 50 ઓમ છે. ઓકે, સો આપણે ટેકનિક કઈ હતી? આપણે ટેકનિકમાં આવું કર્યું હતું કે નાવ વી નો દેટ ધ ક્યુએસ એન્ડ ધ ક્યુપી ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ આપણે એમાં જોયું કે ભાઈ જે આર એલ બાય આરપી હોય, એટલે કે 600 ઓહમ બાય આરપી, એટલે કે સોરી આર એસ 50 ઓહમ હોય, એનો માઇનસ 1, એનો 1/√2 કરવાનો, એટલે આપણને ક્યુ મળે, આન્સર મળશે 3.32 કરી. આ તમને આનો જવાબ મળ્યો. સો નાવ વી નો ધ ક્યુ, તો આપણને એક્સ એક્સ એટલે કે એલ નેટવર્ક આપણે ડિઝાઇન કરી દીધા છે. તો રિએક્ટન્સ બધું છે, દેટ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ અવર ક્યુએસ ઇન્ટુ આર એસ. તો આના બેઝ ઉપરથી એમ કહેવાય ક્યુએસ ઇઝ 3.32 અને આર એસ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ અવર 50 ઓહમ. સો યુ વિલ ગેટ એક્સ એક્સ વિલ ગેટ 166 ઓહમ. સેમ વે આપણે એક્સપી શોધવું હોય તો એક્સપી વિલ બીકમ આરપી બાય ક્યુપી. સો યુ વિલ ગેટ આરપી છે પેરલ 600 ઓહમ લોડ છે અને ક્યુપી તો 3.32 છે. સો યુ વિલ ગેટ 181 ઓહમ. So in short, now you obtain the two reactants which is nothing but can be considered as a आप पर एम कही सकता है कि आना बराबर जो इक्वलेंट फिगर बनाऊं तो कई रीतना बने, तो कि भाई आई हैव ए आई हैव ए द न्यू सी एंड एल टू वेल्यू। हवे हूँ आने नवा कैपेसिटर अने नवा इंडक्टन्स की बात करी, सो व्हाट आई विल गेट सी रिएक्टन्स तो आमाथी मळ से तो 181 होय तो 1 ओवर आई कैन से दैट तो ओमेगा एक्स एक्स कहो देन दैट विल बिकम तमे ओमेगा एटले के अहीं 75 मेगा हर्ट्ज छे तो 75 × 106 इंटू एक्स एक्स इज नथिंग बट योर 166। सो यू विल गेट सम कैपेसिटन्स वैल्यू विच इज नथिंग बट द 1.8 pF while the inductance will become xp by omega and then you will get xp is nothing but apne humne calculate kiya 181 divided by 2 pi into 75 megahertz, so 75 × 10⁶, so in short we'll get the inductance value 384 nH. So in short now the new inductance and capacitance that you have obtained by simply matching these 50 to 600 ohms. So એ પ્રમાણે હવે આપણે અહીંયા જોઈએ તો અહીંયા શું થાય છે કે ભાઈ એક ઇન્ડક્ટર તો હા ઓલરેડી છે અને બીજું ઇન્ડક્ટર તમે અહીંયા પેરેલલમાં મૂકેલું છે, એટલે કઈ રીતના હું ફિગર બનાવીને તમને ક્લિયર થશે, જો સોર્સ હતો 50 ઓહ્મ આ થયો તમારો સોર્સ બરાબર, નાવ યુ ઓબટેન, હવે તમે કેપેસિટર કેટલાનું મળ્યું કે ભાઈ 12.8 એપ્રોક્સિમેટ બરાબર પિકો ફેરાડ એન્ડ આ તમને ઇન્ડક્ટર મળ્યું દેટ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ 384 nH. હવે અહીંયા પાછું બહારના ભાગમાં L2 બરાબર છે એ કેટલું છે કે ભાઈ એ હમણાં આપણે ઉપર જોયું હતું ને, દેટ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ અવર વન વન ટુ પોઈન્ટ સિક્સ અહીંયા હમણાં આપણે કેલ્ક્યુલેટ કરી, અને કેમ કે અહીંયા આપણે ઉપરના ભાગમાં સ્ટેપ વનની અંદર 112.6 nH કેમ કે આપણે રિઝોનેટિવ નેટવર્ક માટે L1 ઓપ્ટેન કરેલું હતું એટલે એ પણ નામ અહીંયા આપણે ડ્રો કરવું પડે, એટલે અહીંયા મેં હવે એને એડ કરું છું, સો દેટ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ યોર 112.6 nH એન્ડ ધેન વી હેવ એ 40 pF કેપેસિટર એન્ડ અવર ફાઇનલ લોડ load and that is nothing but the 600 ohm. So you can see that now I obtained the final final network which is consist of the final matching network. So હવે એવું પણ કરી શકાય કે આ બંને equivalent આપણે L અને C નું કોમ્બિનેશન પણ કરી શકીએ, તો કઈ રીતે કરી શકાય કે એક તો આ બે જે ઇન્ડક્ટર છે આ બંને ઇન્ડક્ટર બે પેરેલમાં છે તો એમનું L ટોટલ કરો, તો L ટોટલ તમને ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ L1 × L2 L1 + L2 હોય તો એનું ઇન્ડક્ટન્સની વેલ્યુ L1ની ખબર છે આ છે L2ની આ છે, તો એ તમે બંનેનું પેરેલ કરો યુ વિલ ગેટ 87 nH. તો અલ્ટિમેટલી યુ વિલ ગેટ ધ ફાઇનલ સર્કિટ S7 ઇન યોર આઈ કેન સે ડેટ હું તમને એમ આમ આ રીતે હું ડ્રો કરી શકું કે જ્યાં ફાઇનલી આઈ વિલ ગેટ 50 ઓહ્મ, દેર ઇઝ એ કેપેસિટર, દેર ઇઝ એ ઇક્વલન્ટ ઇન્ડક્ટર, દેર ઇઝ એ લોડ વિચ ઇઝ નથિંગ બટ યોર 40 pF, દિસ વન ઇઝ યોર ઇક્વલન્ટ 87 nH, દિસ ઇઝ યોર 12.8 pF, દિસ ઇઝ યોર 50 ઓહ્મ and this is your 600 ohm resistive load for RF 600 ohm. So this is what your final circuit, so this I can say that your final circuit for matching this capacitive load So you can see that our objective was to design a matching network that will match with the 50 ohm with the capacitive load, and capacitive load is as shown in figure. So અહીંયા આ ટેકનિકમાં આપણે શું કર્યું કે મેં પહેલાં વહેલાં બે સ્ટેપ કર્યા. પહેલું સ્ટેપ હતું કે જે 40 પીકો ફેરાડે હોય લોડ, રિએક્ટિવ હોય, તો એનું અહીંયા કેપેસિટીવ હતો ઇન્ડક્ટિવ, ઇન્ડક્ટિવ તો કેપેસિટિવ જ નેટવર્ક ઊભું કરી દેવાનું, એટલે કે બંનેનો ઇમ્પેડન્સ છે એવો થઈ જાય કે આ રિએક્ટિવ લોડ જતો રહે અને ઓનલી લોડ રજિસ્ટિવ બની જાય. તો એવું સ્ટેપ કર્યું સ્ટેપ વનમાં. પછી એ જે આવ્યું અને પછી જે રજિસ્ટિવ લોડ વધ્યો હોય એનું નેટવર્ક ડિઝાઇન કરી, એ તો આપણે અગાઉ એલ ટાઈપ નેટવર્ક જ્યારે ડિઝાઇન કરતા હતા એ પ્રમાણે જ કરવાનું હોય, એટલે એ કર્યું. અને એ કર્યા પછી એ એલ અને સીનું નેટવર્ક અને પેરેલલમાં જે આગળનું જે રિઝોનેટિવ નેટવર્ક હોય એના ઇન્ડક્ટરને પણ એડ કર્યું, અને પછી મેં એને થોડુંક સિમ્પ્લિફાઈ કરી, એન્ડ આઈ વિલ ગેટ ધ ફાઇનલ નેટવર્ક વિચ એકચ્યુઅલી મેચ ધ સોર્સ વિથ ધ કેપેસિટી લોડ. સો આર યુ ગેટિંગ? સો ધીસ ઇઝ વોટ the beauty of this these two techniques. પહેલી ટેકનિક છે absorption method ની અંદર મેં કીધું એમ કે જ્યારે જો વેલ્યુ છે એ વધારે ના હોય તો તમે એલ વન ઇઝ ગેટર ધેન એલ એન સીની વેલ્યુ છે એ ગેટર ધેન એલ પી સી પી હોય તો જ પોસિબલ બને, અધરવાઇઝ યુ કેન નોટ અપ્લાય ધેટ ટેકનિક્સ. એટલે અહીંયા રિઝોનન્સ ટેકનિકની મદદથી યુ કેન વેરી ઇઝીલી કેલ્ક્યુલેટ એન્ડ મેચ ધ લોડ, અ કોમ્પ્લેક્સ લોડ. તો આ થયું તમારું સેકન્ડ મેથડ કે તેની મદદથી તમે મેચિંગ કરી શકો. બટ લેટ મી વેરી ઇનશોર્ટ ખાલી હું ટૂંકમાં કહીશ કે એક ધેર ઇઝ અ વન અનધર ટેકનિક એન્ડ ધેટ ઇઝ કોલ્ડ એ થ્રી એલિમેન્ટ ટેકનિક. આપણે એક્ઝામ્પલ નહીં લઈશું પણ ખાલી હું તમને એક જ બીએમ નીટમાં આની વિશે કહીશ કે ધીસ ઇઝ ધ વન ઓફ ધ વેરી સોફિસ્ટિકેટેડ ટેકનિક to do the matching, either whether the load is or resistive sorry source load input or output is a real load or a complex load, you can use these three element matching techniques. So what is the importance, why you have to introduce these techniques? Because what will happen in this earlier two technique or LTAP network, the Q that you will obtain is very very low. So I can say that જ્યારે તમે ક્યુની વેલ્યુ ફાઇન્ડ કરો ત્યારે તમે ફોર્મ્યુલા આવી રાખી હતી કે ભાઈ આર ટી બાય આર એસ માઇનસ વન એન્ડ ઇટ્સ હોલ સ્ક્વેર રૂટ. સો વોટ યુ વિલ ગેટ, યુ વિલ ગેટ ધ લો વેલ્યુ ઓફ ક્યુ. બટ ઇન સમ ઓફ ધ સર્કિટરી યુ નીડ એ વેરી હાઈ વેલ્યુ ઓફ ધ ક્યુ. સો હિયર બીકોઝ ઓફ ધીસ ડીમેરિટ of the low Q, you are using the three element method. So merit of this technique is you will get the high Q. So you can design a very narrow band circuit. So narrow bandwidth can be obtained using this three element technique. તો કઈ રીતના કરાય તો હું તમને કોઈ આપણે એક્ઝામ્પલ નથી આપતો, બટ આઈ વિલ ગીવ યુ સિમ્પલી વન સર્કિટરી કે વન ઓફ ધ વે if you use this way pi network, this is your one of your reactance, this one is your second reactance x2, and there is a third reactance x3. So if you have used this type of the network x3 x2 and x1, and by using the different techniques if you obtain this x3 x2 and x1 values, then you can very easily match this RS with RL. Same way, so this is considered as a pi network, three element pi network. Same way, you can use the second way is a T network. So this is your RS, this is your source, and T is all of you aware, X1. So T is nothing but in this way, this is your X2, and this is your X3, and you will get here RL. So this is considered as a T-type network for the three-element method. So using any one of the pi network or T network, you can you can match the source and load resistance, which either be real or either be complex. So let me clear that these techniques generally be used with the graphical way. એટલે કહેવાનો મતલબ કે આ જે પણ ટેકનિક છે એમાં સ્મિથ ચાર્ટનો યુઝ કરીને જ સ્મિથ ચાર્ટનો યુઝ કરીને યુ આર ગોઈંગ ટુ સોલ્વ ધીસ ઓર યુ આર ગોઈંગ ટુ ઓબટેન ધીસ એક્સ વન એક્સ ટુ એન્ડ એક્સ થ્રી. સો ધીસ ઇઝ નોટ ઇન યોર સિલેબસ, હું કંઈ ડિટેલમાં જતો નથી, બટ ફોર યોર નોલેજ આઈ એમ સેઈંગ દેટ વેન એવર યુ હેવ ટુ ઓબટેન ધ હાઈ ક્યુ, then in that case you have to use three element matching techniques, and using the smith chart you can obtain this x3, x2 and x1 values. So with this I will stop here. I think all of you have now the brief idea about the impedance transformation and the impedance matching, whether it is a real number or whether it is a complex numbers. You can easily mesh the network and you can easily transfer the maximum power. So with this I will stop. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, you can ask me at any point. So